Because the watchword, like a lot of other worlds, whether it's the automobile and sometimes even the fashion world, kind of lives within the world that it does. And sometimes, unless you do something that's disruptive to it, it doesn't really change much, you know? So we're trying to be as disruptive as we can in some of the things that we do there. We had been carrying both in our stores. We had been carrying both vintage watches and at one time IWC in the store as well. I loved the Ernst Benz watches. I had been intrigued by them because I knew that they had a real kind of history and authenticity to them.
I'm a second generation watchmaker that was given the privilege to be at helm of a 50-year-old brand. So you take with heritage and you have to approach with integrity to be able to develop the concept in its natural form. You can be radical with it and how John said disruptive, but you have to pay attention to the history. With John, he allowed me to break outside of that. And each time when we do a project, it's interesting that you had written an article once in IW titled Benz and Friends. It was never my dream to run a watch company. I'm a watchmaker. It was my dream to build watches with my friends. And in a project like with John, I get to push more than everybody else.
These are watchmakers, you know, really understanding what his father started with, and where it's very deep in the bloodline through Lenny. I all of a sudden went from being more interested in Ernst Benz than just carrying some watches in our stores to being intrigued with a family that was true watchmakers that were running a company, designing product, building the product, repairing product for people. And then a couple years into it, maybe not even a couple years into it, Lenny and his PR director at the time came and visited with me about the possibility of doing a limited edition watch with them. And that really turned into, I don't know how many years we've been doing them now, maybe four?
4 years.
4 years of doing the limited edition watches. For having quite a large collection of watches, I pretty much only wear this watch today. And I have other Ernst Benz watches as well, but and being so discerning about what I have on my wrist, I find like I almost don't need the other watches anymore, which is really kind of crazy, because it's kind of the perfect watch for me. It's the perfect scale, it's the perfect detail, it's the perfect patina, it's all the kind of things. And not everything that I do here I can say that about. So then be able to put on the things that I loved about the patina finish on it, the illuminance, the rectangular pushers, all the different things that I always loved about watches that you don't see very much at all today in watches. And you definitely don't see things that have a real kind of patina finish to them at all. And even down to the way we did the straps. There was just like it's all little things. It's not about one thing. It's really about the attention to detail. And that's what I said that's so intriguing to me about working on the watches and loving watches in general, is that you have this very little surface that you can, and the surface is not only is the face, but what goes inside of it, that you, there's only so much you can do with it. And to make it your own. It's like eyeglasses or sunglasses. You know, you have a small temple, a nose piece, the lenses. How do they make them your own? And you have to be good at it. And working together, I think we, you know, I have to say, patting ourselves on the back, I think we did something, and I generally don't say that much, I think we did something good here, you know. And it's fun to see people. I was in an event last night, and somebody there was wearing this particular watch, the original anthracite version of it. He wasn't talking to me. I saw him across the room, but I saw that watch and I was like smiling to myself, like, wow, that's a pretty cool feeling to see that.